Who out there in YouTube Wonderland regrets things from their past? Me! Me!
Me!
All right, guys, here's the deal. We all have regrets, right? In today's video, I'm going to explain to you how to not have them and how to look at them as a benefit, how to make peace with your regrets, or otherwise known as your regrets, and how you can kind of reframe your mindset around these past mistakes that you made. So let me ask you a question. So if you go back to when you were an infant, right? Little Tommy's learning how to walk, right? And he falls. And he gets up and he falls. Are you looking back at little Tommy or little Jane or little whoever you are and be like, what the hell was wrong with me back then? I cannot believe I didn't know how to walk. Like, how stupid was I? Like, I can't believe I did that. Okay? You're probably like, no, Sarah, of course I didn't do that. So why are you regretting things now? Okay? Like, look, I get it. We all have things in the past that we're like, ah, why did I do that? And you're like a little embarrassed, and it kind of like, it's like this weight on you that you just can't seem to lift. And sometimes, say it's regretting a past relationship, right? Maybe you let a toxic or abusive relationship go on for too long. I've been there. And you look back and you're like, what the heck was I thinking? Okay, what the heck was I thinking? And it can kind of resurface when you're getting into new relationships or if you're dating. So how do you move past that? How do you make peace with your past so that you can move forward in life and not have that baggage weighing you down? We're gonna get that baggage off your shoulders, okay? So hang in here with me for a few minutes today and I'm gonna teach you how to do that. So the baby example is really how you should look at every example that you feel like you regret. Think of something in your life that you feel that you regret, or you wish you didn't do, or you wish you didn't say, or you wish you had done something, or whatever. Okay, and I want you to hold that thought in your head. If you want to, comment down below and see if anyone else has gone through something similar. And I want you to think about where it led you, or what it taught you. Because the thing is, as much like when you were an infant, you didn't know any better at that time. Like, as you're sitting here watching this video now, you could certainly go back and say, well, it's easy to walk. You know, I don't fall when I walk anymore, unless you're me and you're klutzy and you fall all the time. That's another story. But in general, like, you don't look back and hold that grudge against yourself when you're learning how to walk. Take that mentality into whatever it is that you feel that you regret in your life now. Okay? We are hopefully constantly growing and evolving and learning throughout lives. So how can you hold yourself accountable for a level of consciousness that you didn't have 5, 10, 20 years ago that you have now? Okay, you can't hold yourself to the same standard as you did 20 years ago or 10 years ago because of the things that you know now. And to even go a little deeper into that, you wouldn't be where you are now without those learning experiences. So you see, you have to understand that as you're growing and evolving and learning, you're becoming a more well-rounded person. You're becoming a wiser person. You're learning more about yourself and what you like and what you don't like and what makes you happy and what makes you sad. And maybe without going through those events, or you said something to this person or whatever it may be, you wouldn't have learned that that was the wrong scenario for you. I personally have a long track record of dating not the best men, or at least for what they were at that time. I don't know who they are now. Maybe they learned from it, but I certainly did. And the thing is if you are going about your life and repeating those things and repeating the mistakes or regrets, then, like, yeah, you still have to learn the lesson because you're still making the same mistake again. But the whole point in having those regrets and in making those mistakes is so that you learn from them and you don't do it again, and you can better craft your future for something that you do like. Maybe you had a job that you regretted doing and you didn't like it, but you learned that you didn't like it. So then when you move forward, you progress in life, you're not doing the same thing again. And the biggest thing to keep in mind is you are always doing the best you can at that time, in that moment, with whatever knowledge you have at that time and whatever you know and whatever you don't know what you don't know, right? So like, how could you know without going through that or without making that decision that it wasn't the right decision for you? So in reality, aren't you always kind of making the right decision for you? Because it's always leading you to the next step. So you see, it's always a step forward, even if it feels like a step backward, because you're always gaining knowledge and you're gaining wisdom. And on top of that, here's another twist. As you're learning and going through these things, you're creating a way to help other people in the future. So, for example, a video I did a few videos ago about like how to relieve yourself of anxiety. Well, how could I help you and make a video on here of helping you to get rid of your anxiety if I didn't go through it myself? You have a book out there to write. You have a song to create. You have a movie script to write. You have advice to give other people you may or may not know because of these past regrets and mistakes. So don't downplay them and don't beat yourself up about them, because in those regrets and in those mistakes is magic. A mistake is never really a mistake unless you give it the power to be one, unless you let it weigh you down like it is one. So give yourself grace and know that you were doing the best that you could in that moment, and that it's okay, and that you're not gonna live a perfect life. You're not gonna make the right decision every single time, but every decision is gonna get you one step closer, one step further. It's gonna be able to help one more person. So just think of it that way. Like, you're always where you're supposed to be right now in this moment. You got here because of the things you went through, positive or negative. And most times the negative things are the ones that shape us to who we are. They make us stronger. They make us more resilient. They make us more powerful and more, they bring us self-love. So let it bring you self-love. Don't let it bring self-hate. Don't go back and yell at 16-year-old little Johnny, okay? 16-year-old little Johnny was doing the best that he could. 16-year-old Johnny isn't gonna make the same decisions that 30-year-old Johnny makes. Just like 30-year-old Johnny isn't gonna make the same decision as 55-year-old Johnny makes. All right, so just like, chillax. Give yourself some grace, give yourself some breathing room, and have gratitude for the things that you've gone through, because it has made you who you are today. So I'm gonna sit here, I'm gonna ask you guys, what's one thing that you regret or you feel that you made a mistake in your past that you actually see as a good thing? Comment down below, I want to know, I would love to hear your story. Okay, how did it make you stronger? How did it teach you a lesson? How did it help you help someone else? Mistakes are a beautiful thing. Millionaires and billionaires don't get there typically on the first shot. They make a bunch of mistakes to get there. You don't typically marry the first person you date when you're 16 or 15 or whatever. It takes a few mistakes to get there. I made the mistake of not charging my camera before I filmed, and now I will learn from that mistake and make sure it's charged the next time I film a YouTube video. And also, look at my little kitty. This is my little stash. See, isn't she so cute? Say hi, YouTube. And if Sassy never made the mistake of getting lost, we would have never found her and she wouldn't be here right now. So my whole point is our past builds us. It makes us stronger, okay? God is never going to give us something that we cannot handle. Do you hear that? God is never going to give us something that we cannot handle. There's things in your past that you felt like you probably couldn't get past, and here you are. And there's gonna be things that happen in the future that you feel like you're not gonna be able to get past, but you will. Our past builds us and it makes us stronger and it prepares us for what's going to come in the future so that we can handle those things better and with more knowledge and wisdom and grace. I hope it brings you so much peace to know that the things that you've been through were done to you on purpose to build you and to build your character. And then it's all gonna be okay. So give yourself some grace, love yourself, and know that you're never gonna live a perfect life. You're always gonna make mistakes. And that's just a part of life, and that's part of the process of evolving and becoming a more loving and peaceful and happy human being. I love you guys so much. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe so you can hang out with me again next week. Don't forget, be limitlessly yourself.